Hello friends, I'm Kevin and welcome to our channel Be Limitless. Hope you guys are doing well. Well, I'm here with today's topic on limitations of accounting. So let's move ahead. What is the limitations? What are the limitations of accounting? The most important limitation is historical in nature. Accounting is historical in nature. That means accounting reflects the past position of business organization. Financial accounting consider only those transactions. Just remember, financial accounting consider only those transactions which are historical in nature. That is the transaction which have already taken place. No futuristic transaction find any place in financial accounting. No matter how important it is. For example, I've given the example on the screen. The Washington company constructed a building at a cost of $45,000 in 2005. On December 31st, 2017, the fair market value of the building is $65,000, but still stands on the balance sheet at its original cost, that is of $45,000. In the balance sheet, we cannot just increase the original cost of the building just because the market price of the building is increased. So, the Washington company, as constructed the building at a cost of $45,000, so it will still show the value, the original value at which the building was constructed, that is $45,000, not the current market value. Just remember, not the current market value. Another example is the New York company purchased a tract of land for $50,000 on January 1, 2010. Now today, if the fair market value of the land is $65,000, although the company economic value or market price of the land has increased, the company would continue reporting at its historical, that is original cost, that is $50,000. So accounting is historical in nature. Okay, just remember, accounting is historical in nature. It will continue showing the original cost, original value of the assets, not the current market value or the market price. The second most important limitation of accounting is it records only monetary transaction. One of the biggest limitation of accounting that it cannot measure things, events that do not have monetary value. If a certain factor, no matter how important it is, cannot be expressed in money, it finds no place in accounting. Just remember, it can only measure things, it can only record things which have a monetary value, which can be measured in terms of money. Just for example, if I'm a director or the owner of a company, and see, we all know that humans are the biggest assets of an organization, but still that cannot be measured in terms of their skills, cannot be measured in terms of money. So there is nowhere mentioned the monetary value of the humans in the balance sheet. So if I fire or hire someone, it cannot be recorded in the books of accounts. So the biggest limitation is that it cannot measure things, events that do not have a monetary value. The definition you can see on the screen. third limitation is price level changes. Now, accounting statements do not show the effect of price level changes on the value of assets, since it is based on historical cost. As we have discussed before, that accounting, the limitations of accounting is that accounting is based on historical cost. It will only show the historical, the original value of the asset, not the current market value. Thus, the financial position, as we usually show, as per the generally accounting accepted principles, may not come true in some cases of inflation or deflation, where inflation or deflation is on a higher level, because it doesn't show, our balance sheet doesn't show the effect of price level changes. If suppose I have purchased a machinery, for example, at $10,000, and after 5 years, the depreciation, by putting the depreciation, the value of the machinery has been decreased to $4,000. So the actual cost remains the same, or the value of the machinery, or the value of the land. Suppose, for example, I have purchased the land for $50,000, and the after 5 years, the land value has been increased to $10,000. So I'm not going to reflect the effect of price level changes on the balance sheet. So the value of money changes due to inflation. Accounting statements are prepared at historical cost. Money as a measurement unit changes in value. It does not remain stable unless price level changes are considered. While preparing financial statements, accounting information will not show true results. If we want to predict the actual financial results, we have to consider the price level changes factor. We will consider, then only we will get the true and fair picture of the financial position. We will discuss and we will come to know all these things deeply in our upcoming videos. So stay tuned. At accounting principle, the fourth limitation is window dressing. Accounting principle, now what is window dressing? Accounting principles are not static. Information contained in accounting, whatever information we are providing to the company, whatever information we are reflecting in the balance sheet, that may be changed or manipulated by various factors. We can change the net profit, or assets can be increased or decreased depending on the requirement of the management. So accounting is subject to window dressing, and it fails to depict the true financial positions of the enterprise if the accounts were not drawn properly. Now everything has a loopholes. Everything has a loopholes. Now these are the loopholes of accounting. That is why it is known as the limitations of accounting. Accounting information can be manipulated through various ways, through the method of charging depreciation, through the method we are using to record the transaction in our books, the viewpoint of an accountant. There are so many factors. We will discuss it further. The fifth limitation of accounting is personal biasness. In some cases, some events are measured on the basis of some estimates. In such cases, judgment of the person who is estimating the events plays a vital role in accounting. So we can say that accounting gets influenced by personal judgments. If we are in favor of something, definitely we can change the result of accounting. The sixth one is real value not known. Accounting is based on various generally accepted accounting principles. Sometimes the record prepared in accounting fail to show a true and fair position of profitability and financial soundness of the business enterprises. It means the actual value of asset is known. Most important, I repeat it again, the actual value of asset is known on the date on which the business is actually sold. For example, I am using a particular machinery. Okay, so the actual value is, I will come to know of that particular machinery on the particular date on which I have sold the business, and the amount of value in terms of money I have realized by selling that particular machinery. So that is the actual value. Until and unless the business is not sold, the business is not closed, we cannot determine the actual life of the business, we cannot determine the actual realizable value of the asset, whatever assets we are having. We can only predict, and we can predict by acquiring few methods, accounting methods, accounting principles, which we usually follow on the original cost of the assets to predict the value. But actual value we would come to know until and unless the business is not sold. So our next topic would be basic accounting terms. So stay tuned. So friends, please share as much as possible, like, subscribe, and stay tuned to the channel, because we update regular knowledgeable videos on a daily basis. Share as much as possible. Thank you so much for watching. Take care.